So, hello everyone, I just want to make a quick video today about the bata. So the bata is the lower part of the stick, and it's really one of the defining aspects of what we do in Irish stick fighting, and with an Antrim Bata. So the purpose of this little appendix is a little bit misunderstood. And most historical sources, they'll tell you that the Irish fight this way to protect their elbow, their forearm, which is quite valid. This is how we use it, but it can also be used in different ways. So first off, when I'm in guard against somebody, of course, my forearm is going to be a target. But with the bata right in front, I can easily protect this target against incoming blows. The same thing when I'm actually striking. So usually, if I want to strike with a stick, in order to keep my forearm protected, I want to be moving this forearm and protecting it with the movement of my stick. We don't quite need that in Irish stick fighting because, again, we've got this guard here. That you've got a picture is like basically the guard of a saber. Protecting not necessarily your hand, but protecting your forearm. So when I'm striking, I can use this to protect myself. So if I didn't have this bata here, it'll be very easy for Callum here to snipe my forearm, but here I can actually protect myself and even use this as a single time parry. So that's another use of the bata. I can also use, of course, a stab. If, let's say, I parry a strike, I can use it here as a dagger. I can use it two-handed like a bayonet. And some people will also ask me sometimes if you can use it to hook, meaning that, well, can I use it, let's say I'm in a parry, can I use it to hook his hand and then maybe get into some fancy disarm? I can always do that. And you see a lot of this in some types of eskrima sometimes when they'll use a little bit of a shorter butt hand here to do those disarm. And that's perfectly valid. The problem we have in our style is that the bata is a lot longer. Now, as long as, if you strike me here, as long as I keep Cal very close to my wrist, there's not a problem. I've got a very good leverage. But it's very easy for him to get out. And once he gets past the middle of my bata, he actually has a better leverage than I do and can disarm me in return. So that's why we don't tend to really use that. You could do it with two hands. Let's say I'm again the same situation. If I grab my stick two hands, then even if he gets away, I still have a very good lever. But the problem here is both my hands are in my stick, and he can always use his harder hand to punch me, to grab me. So maybe not the best situation to be in, but that could be an option. Not a traditional one that we teach in our style, but that could always be done. But yeah, that's mostly why we don't hook this way, as you will see in our nest, where a smaller portion of the stick is used to grab. If the opponent gets out, he gets out and we start again. Here, if he gets too low, that's dangerous for me. So usually I'm not gonna use my bata in this way. So that was a small video on one of the aspects of Irish stick fighting that I think are the most interesting. Hope you liked it, and I'll be making some other small videos in the future.